And for more on the best tips to finding happiness, I'm joined now by an expert in the field, Caroline Adams-Miller, author of Getting Grit and Creating Your Best Life. So, Caroline, does the finding of this study surprise you that spending money on a cleaner rather than a handbag can make you happier?
No. We've known in the field of positive psychology for well over 10 years, maybe longer, that money does not buy happiness. So investing in things doesn't make people happier. It's experiences that make people happier. But I think the interesting thing behind this particular study is it's our perception of time, I think, that really matters. It's what do we think about the time that we have available. So what if you're actually buying, you know, cleaning and gardening and other kinds of things, but you're not spending the time that it gives you on anything that's meaningful? So that's really where my concern would be, because you can fill it with anything, but is it meaningful?
Okay. Yeah. But do you think this is particularly applicable to women, who are so often the head of the household, who do so many chores and maybe don't feel that they can pay someone else because they think it's their responsibility? Should they go for it?
Yes. The answer is yes. And so my concern really is about women, because we see this worldwide phenomenon that women at middle age are dying younger now from diseases of despair. And some of that is because they don't feel purposeful. And so if they do free up time, what are they going to do with it? So you have to have a purpose. You have to have what we call in positive psychology an ikigai. What do you wake up for? What are the things that you plan to do that are meaningful to you? Because if you free up time and you're not ready to answer that question, and you don't have goals, particularly hard goals, in place, you can just take that time and fritter it away. And when you have multitasking going on, you can perceive that you don't have time too. So simply being distracted creates the same anxiety.
Okay, so how do we find our goals for what we should do with that time that we free up if we get a cleaner?
Ask yourself, what will I regret not pursuing if I don't start now? If I'm looking back on my life, what have I done? And if I haven't started now, if I don't have a plan to go after the things that are really important to me, women in particular, then what we have is this coulda, shoulda, woulda phenomenon. And if you don't go after things now, the risks you take now are the things you will not regret. The ones that you don't take are the ones that are really going to make your life difficult and toxic. And in particular, you have to have this quality of grit, because hard goals are what bring us the greatest joy. Hard goals that are important to us. But you have to have this quality of grit or you won't be a finisher.
Right. And do you feel like with our current culture of instant gratification fueled by social media and likes, that works against a long-term grit culture and finding happiness?
We can't pay attention to things anymore. Again, technology takes us off task. And so we as human beings can't even focus as long as a goldfish anymore. So human beings can focus for 7 seconds and goldfish for 8. And so we do have an instant gratification culture. So I've written a lot about this, because we have to learn patience, we have to learn self-regulation, but we have to have our goals ready for the time we do create for ourselves, right?
Wonderful advice. Caroline Adams-Miller, thank you so much for joining us.